get ready for a blissful move through the streets. We're walking to the early moments of travelogue, to the wonderful bliss of Martin Russian's incredible producing of the Dare LP. This is Def Galaxia.
Out of another galaxy. Dance Vision, 1977. A band known as The Future. Formed out of Sheffield. In its machinic grey, it developed a sense of mystery, but beauty at the same time. In its discovery electronics, they soon formed into the human league.
Cityscape. Let's rock on and check out the Human League.
Catalog music.
Street walking.
A footnote here, before the Human League came on, there was a band, a support, that I didn't manage to catch their name as they were coming in and everything, but some interesting vocoder there, and some hexagon drum filter things, but I did notice, a couple years before, I think, in Europe, the support actually was Heaven 17. And as you all know, well, before that, they were all Human League, the beginning days, and then with Adrian Wright with his film slide stuff. But yeah, it would have been amazing to see Heaven 17, Soul Warfare and Fuck, I'm Your Money, some great tracks by them. So yeah, there you go.
Come on.
French disco, boogie sounds. Incidentally, yeah, messing around with my keyboard and my Nero things. And with the Human League, I was trying to find the video cassette, and I found it now, but I wanted to get it signed. But here's a couple of other musical taste notes there for you to look at. A bit of Twilight Zone. And then the gang movies on original VHS as well. I've kept kind of everything, haven't I? So if you're interesting movies there, and then your drug stuff, yeah, some good shit there. Android science fiction. So yeah, coming back in that nice citron colour car. Or was it the green one? No, I don't remember actually. But I do remember some of the night, and I gave, well, it was just mayhem with security, really. So I took my central station bag in and brought some records in, and somehow, by the skin of my teeth, I got in there and had some records signed from Philip Oakey, Joanne and Suzanne. So yeah, there's Life on Your Own 12-inch. You can see there, that's some nice signatures for me, as well as the actual Human League ticket. So here's another one, the Lebanon 12-inch. So very happy, very ecstatic about that. You know, a fantastic show. You can see for yourself in some of the visions there with the lighting and the big keyboard guitars. Philip Oakey's voice, fucking phenomenal. Just how he's kept it so good over the years. So yeah, a few 12-inches signed here. Soundtrack to A New Generation 12. Love Is All That Matters 12. Which has got an extended remix. Look, look at that one. They, right by their faces, they did all their signatures, so I was absolutely ecstatic. I Love You Too Much dub version on here, which I really like. And then to top it off at the end, a Human League mega mix, which they all signed as well. So, yeah, all in all, you'll see, you know, I didn't really get too many wild interviews on this one. It was very, you know, you were just, yeah, stuck and cramped, you know. So, yeah, just back in the den with my electric boogie beat, chilling with my PJ35 and my Sansui amphitheater Yamo. So, fully automatic silver. And I'm back at ya. This is Cybex. Enjoy. Thank you.
Luzertronic. Mono, stereo, stereo.
Record market, and Cybex is coming back out again for a little bit of a dig through an amazing guy I've known for a while, Mark. He runs Record Market and has been at the fairs for many years. My first kind of recollections was actually a time where a tire blew out on his back of his trailer, and he was out going to the West End fair, and he was like sliding the crates like a bowling alley. Tell us a bit about those times, mate, Mark.
Oh, mate, those were the days, absolutely. It was many years ago, I had a blowout on a tyre, and out on the way to West End, so...
That's right,
good
yeah.
Good fair West End.
Oh, hell yeah, and the Macrovat ones were pretty cool. They had a few around the place that, it was just dynamic. A lot of sellers from Sydney would come up too, and it was something else. But you've been basically... from the early days into playing your guitar and the surf rock and the punk and all that.
So. Oh yeah, I've been doing the fairs since, the first fair I did was East Leagues Club. A guy called John Novak used to run the fair there.
Right.
And this is 91, 92.
Yeah, yes, I have some recollection of that, yes.
And then from there we went to Elizabeth Arcade. The old Elizabeth Arcade.
Elizabeth Arcade,
in the city, which is opposite the Meyer Centre. And that was, through to the late 90s. And then they ended up at Mount Gravatt.
That's right. That's right.
And then West End.
Yeah.
Later on. But it was a different guy running it then.
That's right. And what about some of the early records, the influences there? Like, we were talking about Mio 245, how amazing they are, and Wall of Voodoo. And
oh, yeah.
Yeah, so that was... That was, I mean, there's a lot of Australian new wave stuff.
I've always loved my Aussie punk and metal and new wave stuff, so yeah. Hoodoo Gurus, Lime Spiders, you know.
Lime Spiders,
Radio
yes.
Radio Birdman, Celibate Rifles.
Celibate Rifles, that's right. And you've Rizzy had a
bands like, you know, like Go Between, say, or Riptides.
The Riptides, yeah,
all
that's
these sort
right.
of early bands.
That's
punk,
right.
Punk, alternative rock.
Yep, that's right.
Ska bands, even. There used to be a band from Brisbane called the Furious Turtles that were pretty good.
Wow, the Furious Turtles.
They're a ska band.
A ska band.
Well, very rare EP, that one.
Yep. Well, Ska's taken off, and Triple Z have always been playing it here in Brisbane. So, but we're down at Southport, and you've had some various shops too. One at Mermaid Waters.
Yeah.
Elongated type of shop. And then another one there at Southport. But now we've moved again, and it's getting big with the piles now, and it's a digger's desire. It's the pot of gold, really. I mean, you've got probably the biggest collection around to dig through. And,
well, I've got a lot of 12s, but it's just a bit of disorganisation at the moment, unfortunately,
that's right.
because of having to move from a big place to a small place. So
yeah.
But anyway.
Well, that's right. Well, we're going to go through. We're going to have a little dig today, and I'll see what happens. But thanks very much, Mark, for showing us the shop.
Everybody's always welcome, and you'll get the best deal in town.
Absolutely. That's it. All right, Mark. Thanks, buddy.
All right. Thanks, Alex. Too easy.
All right. Wicked.
It's not what to do. A passage of a benign and visual kind. To stand and follow fashion, the act seems so sublime. Grotesque in admiration, but in some exceeding mass. Then whose thoughts are borrowed, and whose thoughts are fast?
Ah, yes, 7 inches. Got a wonderful display up here. Going through.
Well, I had intentions of maybe speaking out last night for a couple of hours after I got back, did all this loading, etc.
Yeah.
And then what I have to do.
There's the giant penguin. He's making sure that you select the dopest grooves you can. So, yeah. Wow. Alright. I'm going to make my way to the back room where all the dance 12 inches are and find something. Alright. Let's edge our way through. There's things everywhere. I will probably need to use this step ladder because you really have to get up high with these piles. Oh, look at that, there's a human cardoon. Cardon. Tape deck. Oh, I've got a CD recorder of one of that brand. Look, there's your fucking drum kit up the top. My gosh. Stack it up, y'all. This is kind of reminds me of the Scratch DVD. DJ Shadow was talking about. It's like you're walking in a big pile of dreams, you know. Some made it, some didn't, but they all ended up in here. And he also said he found a mummified bat between the records. That's a great documentary, that one. Scratch, there's all the 7 inches in there loaded up. So, oh man. So you can see, literally, I'm walking on top of 7 inches now. So, that's what it takes when you want to find the ultimate. Hey? You just can spend hours and hours looking and sifting and then listening. Find that ultimate dub version or remix or original funk record on a label. Just keep going and going, man. Just get darker, like a basement. Dinge. Man, these boxes aren't even open out there, it looks like. It just goes and goes. Rows and rows. Man. Oh, don't you love it? Oh, man. I'm just going to sift through, see what I can get. There'll be some acid house in here, there'll be some Italo disco, 90s techno, of course. Sunny view. There you go. Record Market, which basically was derived from the earlier name Record Market, which had the Aboriginal guy on the didgeridoo on their paper bags that sell the records as their art design for the shop. So there we go, Record Market. Digging it. Alright, so been digging down and ran into an old friend, actually, Glenn.
Hey.
And Glenn, he's got some amazing records at home, and we're just talking about...
Having caught up for ages. It's almost been a decade. It's
a decade. And tell him about some of the early kind of, you know, that new wave kind of sort of electronic stuff that influenced you, I guess, in the 80s. I mean, Depeche Mode and... You know.
Yeah. Look, I'm all over the shop in taste, but electronic. Look, I love The Cure. I loved, you know, Smith's New Order.
Yeah,
Pet Shop
that's
Boys.
Right.
I grew up.
That's right.
I mean, where do you go from there? Everything.
Yeah, the Pet Shop Boys. Geez, they put out just 12-inch after 12-inch. That was just dynamite. You know what I mean? Like, they never.
Indeed.
And they're still putting out albums, aren't they? They're still doing stuff.
Yeah, and if something's coming out soon. I haven't heard it, but I've got to look into it.
Yeah, I got the there was a grey album with the shadows on it.
Hotspot.
Hotspot.
That's okay.
Hotspot. It's okay. So definitely. We're talking about Trust. Is a new kind of dark wave.
Newer sort of the new school.
The new school of electronic
dark wave. Pop.
That's it. So it's good to catch up and you know, come on down and you never know who you're gonna run into.
It's been years.
It's been bloody many years. So word up to you.
Or a heart of stone. Just you wait till I get you home. All your stuff installing and starting. Who do you think you are, Joe Starling? Sometimes you're better off dead. There's a gun in your hand, it's pointing at your head. In Western time, the dead end world. The Eastern boys and Western girls.
town of dead world. Eastern boys, Western girls, Western girls.
On the Electone, MME10. We're doing it again, again. The fresh speaker down below. Let's get up to the tempo. Let's rock Surface Paradise. Yeah.
Well, that's pretty cool, isn't it?
Just got the rap beat happening.
The rap beats are happening. We're in the mix. We got the keyboard in. So come down and do some live rapping with this drum beat. Dope.
A mirror reflects the light in the way that depends on how the signal was recorded there in the first place. And this varying pattern of light is turned into an electrical signal which will eventually produce sound and pictures.
All right. So another young collector, old school collector. I've seen him so many times in the shop. And originally from UK, is that right?
New Zealand.
New Zealand, right. I got that wrong a bit. But you were right into all the underground resistance and various electronica. And early disco, a lot of early disco as well, I noticed. What were some of the labels, with the early disco that you've enjoyed?
Oh, look.
West End Records?
It's a bit hard to say. On the spot.
I know.
So many. Prelude, probably.
Prelude, yeah, absolutely. They're a good one.
Is it Atlanta? A lot of the, you probably got me on the spot here, but
Well, what about like Profile and stuff like that? I mean, the Atlantic would just put out certain dance records that were just aimed at, some were new wave, some were
GQ.
GQ?
Bands like that got me into a lot of, really well-produced disco. And I guess, but I really just, tread through it a little bit. I didn't get too deep into it.
Right.
I mean, I went from total indie music, and I guess when I was a teenager, I was into bands like King Crimson and Pink Floyd, which led me to Brian Eno, Talking Heads.
Yeah.
And all the whole stream of sort of rhythmic, I guess a lot of rhythmic sort of stuff from the from the late 70s into the 80s.
Yeah, well, we've got this whole post-punk thing going on as well. With the electronica going into the American Detroit sort of stuff, Kenny Larkin and all that
So I went to London. I went to London in 96 and worked for Rough Trade. And
did you? Wow.
Through working there, the guys would come in with the latest UR and the latest Jeff Mills and stuff. So it was sort of exciting. It was a really exciting time, and also Super Discount was coming out at the time, a lot of French disco.
Oh wow. So, F Communications is a French label, right?
Yeah, a lot of that stuff too. So, I was exposed to a lot of that stuff over there, and then when I came back, I started buying it for Red Eye in Sydney. They let me
I remember that shop
from Watts in New York.
Yeah.
Distributed a lot of that UR stuff. Submerge stuff.
And Submerge, yes. That's a Submerge was a major distributor, wasn't it?
And then things like Herbert, Matthew Herbert. I got into a lot of his deep house stuff, and that led me into a lot of, Charles Webster, earlier, and then getting into the early deep house and stuff. But I guess I come from a more alternative angle, so I wasn't brought up in the rave sort of era, so...
It's just discovery in expansions of what you're listening to. You're kind of opening up the book more and more.
Yeah, so late to the party, late to the, as far as dance music's concerned. But, it's just been a really enjoyable experience educating myself on a lot of the history, classic tracks and stuff.
That's right, history. Oh, it's all about history and movement through the histories, really. To what's today, there's many things doing... redoing old things with some of the stuff I was talking with, the dark wave stuff.
Dark Entry's been putting out reissuing a lot of that classic synth stuff, which is really hard to get now. So I guess there's been another wave of that, and there's been another wave of edits of disco tracks.
That's right.
Stuff. So
them.
Oh,
yeah.
That's good. Well, it's, you're still alive with it, and you're still running through.
Know,
and
I don't do it. don't DJ professionally, but I love to DJ at home, and I collect music just to build up a repertoire so that I've got plenty to choose from. And I have a play a 3-hour mix or something on a Friday night, record them onto I've got a mixer with USB record.
Yeah.
So that's been fantastic. You know, being able to record myself and just, you know,
That's right.
Mixes for the car and whatever.
Yeah, well, I was just saying I had a Harman Kardon. I record onto CD and stuff. There was a mixtape up there. But yeah, that's wonderful, mate. Well, thank you very much for having a bit of a chat with us.
Yeah, thank you.
And yeah, let's just keep digging and let's find that pot of gold.
Absolutely, thank you.
All right. Okay, we had a great time in there. Just finishing off, Mark showed me this record with the signature he has there from Johnny O'Keefe, the Australian artist. And there's another signature there we're trying to work out, right? What do you think, Mark?
Don't know, it could be someone else in the band, but yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely, I bought it at an antique fair.
Yep.
And it was just a good find. So I'm going to go and buy some records off a guy this afternoon, off a lady actually, and her dad was in his band.
Right.
The drummer in his band.
Drummer in his band.
I'm going to take this record along and show it to her.
Wow, a bit of nostalgia, definitely.
So she'll appreciate that.
Absolutely, mate. Thanks very much for the shop. It was wicked. Love it.
No,
record market.
Have a great day.
We'll be back. Always got to come back for more records. No doubt about it. Word up to the city, y'all! Gold Coast! down the alley we go. So, there we go, Southport. Southport in the rain. Tram, no pain. Wow, just got back after that deluge in the rain, but this is the amazing electro track that I found today. It's a killer, this one. So let's have a briny and sit back and have a little look at what I got today. Incidentally, I got the Magic Force of Conk, 1981 to 1988. It's a triple pack, fantastic. Comes with a booklet and a poster. It's great. I really wanted it for that track. That was in the Michael J. Fox film. So anyway, today I got Ken Ishii, an old one on R&S, crazy label. This one, I'll have to check this thing out. Offbeat stuff. A Jungle record, Channel 5, Austin M. So I've got something else by that guy. Camp Low, featuring Camp Low. So I've got some Camp Low stuff. Lucchini, this is it, the classic they did. Unusual bass with some singing through it, this one. Jake, Fairly, Crisis EP, check that out. And this is very nice too, I noticed that, but I'll give these a clean up. Usually I just use the bit of water with a bit of metho and she does the trick. Mouseville, another one. Kids in the Kitchen, still trying to get the 12-inch, Change in Mood, but wanted to get a nice clean copy of Shine, the album Save, the Torch is Shine as well, and Something She Said, the dub version's mad. Yeah, so Baby Oliver, this one, an interesting old one from Rocking Horse originally. It's had a nice mellow bit in here, very cool. So, yeah, this is a trippy one. So, another copy of this one, more your sort of funk, sort of Italo kind of funk stuff. Tom Powell, You've Got It All.
You've got it all.
Hot Tracks, Look of Love. A hip-hop kind of beat mix of it on the Hot Tracks, which is kind of different. Yeah. So, where are we here? This one. Sort of jazzy house stuff. Some techie sort of stuff I bought as well. This one's quite techie. That was alright. Janet Jackson, Diamonds, plus Shy Boys, Anna, on a Hot Tracks there. Gordon, there you go. There's the guy of the big collection, Gordon. Oh, and you can't go past getting a good copy of Rock the Bells. That's if you can get a good copy. It's usually thrash to the fuck, because every DJ in his, was smashing this, DMC and everything. So LL, Rock the Bells, not bad. I got that in all right condition. So good live recordings, did some electro stuff. This one's okay. I'll have to check that out. Primary, I've got another one on this label, so I bought that one. Dreams Unlimited, more of a Ravey House thing, or something I don't know. Jenny Morrison, I do know, tease me, another 12-inch I didn't have, but Techno Freaks is the big 12-inch, probably to get of her, him. Tokyo 18, so I got two copies of this. This is the Mavinelli Project. Very good, Blue Street EP. Carol Hahn, Do Your Best. So more of your funk again, disco funk on Malaco label. Into more disco, Mantis. All right, so that's another one, Mantis. SMA. Okay. A few medleys too. This is a really bizarre medley that uses fucking hell. It just goes a bit everywhere with some of the mixings very offbeat, but. I found it very interesting, you know, it's got the Doors and all that going through there. All this writing and shit, so that's cool. Formerly from The Limit, this guy has done a 12, a kind of a jazz funk thing, kind of cool. As well as this, another sort of jazz funk again. Magic, Blue Magic, Mirage. So. Just going on to the other side of that record, fuck me dead. Microthel, I think, versus DJ Glow. Wireheads, fucking dope. So just ending off, and got prepared to energize Torch Song as well. I thought that's an earlier William Orbit release, but on Illegal Records, that's quite a great track, good old 80s track. Just for the photo, man. Fucking hell. Getting wild. And ending up, I never heard the dub version on this. I don't know why. It was always trash and I found one. I finally got a good copy. What's on your mind? Pure Energy. Information Society. So, yeah. So, word up and fresh. Keep Select to the death. Galaxian Effect. Act.